honestly think this may have been the best trip I've ever taken in my entire life. It's your sign. If you've been wanting to do it, do it.
Today and literally on my way back home, I was bawling my eyes out. Like, I was so, I guess, like, I'm feeling, I don't know, like, I can't say that I'm feeling a lot of emotions because it doesn't feel like I'm overwhelmed with emotions. It's just like subconsciously, I guess, I'm sad because this trip is different than all my other trips in the past. So I love to travel, but I always had somebody to travel with me. So this is my first solo trip, and I guess like I was crying because I'm like, wow, like I have nobody to share this excitement with. I have nobody to share this experience with. I always desire to have one person to experience life with, and right now I don't have that. So the universe and God is just telling me to just do it on my own until that person tags along. So I literally leave tomorrow. It doesn't feel real right now. Like, at moments it hits where I'm like, damn, like I'm really gonna be somewhere and like in a different place by myself, and like sometimes I'm like, damn, but for the most part, like, I don't really feel it. Like, it's not hitting me. It feels not, it doesn't feel real right now. I'm gonna be okay. I know that I am, and I know that I'm gonna enjoy myself and I'm gonna have a great time. I booked a lot of excursions and like activities to do so that I'm not like just wandering around, not knowing what to do. I have something set for every day. And I'm just going to take you guys along with me on my trip. It's going to be exciting, but also scary, but it's like, I need to do it. I'm just bringing extra bathing suits just in case, cause you never know. Bueno, nunca sabe, cause you never know. And I made it a point to practice speaking Spanish with while I'm over there. Like, I have to. So I'm just gonna finish packing and then I'll update you guys with my emotions and everything that I'm feeling as the time gets closer.
So I'm recording on my phone because my camera is packed away. I'm all packed, by the way. I'm all set. I keep like overthinking, like double checking, triple checking if I remembered everything. I just got in bed. And I was scrolling on TikTok to like ease my mind because I feel like I'm starting to overthink about it a lot now because the time is like coming soon, like it's approaching fast. And I was scrolling on TikTok and I was scrolling through my following list, and my absolute favorite YouTuber just put, like, it's literally like so crazy because I love her. I love her videos. I love her content. And she just posted a TikTok of her doing her first solo trip, just like me, to Puerto Rico, just like me. So it just made me feel so much more confident and like secure and going. And it kind of eased my mind a little bit because it's like, if you could do it, I can do it. We're both from New York. Oh, her name is Ketora, by the way. I didn't even say her name. Ketora. I don't know if I say it right. And like the timing of it is crazy because she just came back, I think. And I'm about to leave. So, but yeah.
Good morning. So today is the day that I go to Puerto Rico. It's 7:33 and I have to leave in like 10 minutes. I'm all packed. I just have to put some last minute things in my bags. I have my incense lit right now and I said my intentions before I leave. And my intentions are to have a safe trip, have a fun trip, have a spiritually healing trip as well. I want to grow during this trip. This will be my first solo trip, so obviously a lot of growth will come with that. I intend on meeting amazing people, getting out of my comfort zone, speaking in Spanish, and just like unlocking a new experience of love in my life. And I think that this will really do it for me.
So I prayed over my trip and I set my intentions for the trip and I'm just super excited. I'm not nervous right now. Shockingly, you would think as it like, cause yesterday I was feeling nervous. I was feeling a little anxious yesterday, last night. But today I'm actually excited. Like I'm ready to be there already. And yep. So this is my airport fit. I just have these and this, and then I'm just gonna wear this sweater over it. And then this is also gonna be my outfit if it gets like a little chilly, so that I have a sweater and then I have pants. Oh my gosh, guys. So I have this thing called Affirmators, and it's basically like affirmation cards. I got this from my sister for Christmas, and I was like, okay, like I should, like today is a perfect day to pick a card. So I was shuffling the cards and one of them popped out and I was like, okay, this is the one. It's love. And I was literally just saying how I want to unlock like a new experience of love on my trip. And then I got love. So it's a sign. But it's just so cute that I got love. I'm excited now. I'm even more excited. Okay, so I'm at the airport and I'm very excited. Like I want to be there already. I'm burning hot right now though. I'm here super early. So I have a lot of time until I even board the plane. So I'm going to just be chilling for like over an hour.
All customers should be on board at gate number 17, final call. Attention on the terminal, all JetBlue customers traveling on JetBlue flight 20.
Okay, I finally made it on the plane. It was a delay. We had to wait like 30 extra minutes, but I'm on the plane. I have a window seat. And I'm very sleepy. I'm definitely gonna take a nap during this time. Okay, so I'm here now. This is exciting. I'm about to get my Uber and then we're gonna go to the BNB. I'm so excited. Guys, I just got to the Airbnb and you know what's crazy? I arrived here at 4:44. I tried to get my camera out really quickly so I could try to record the time, but I was too late. And then I called my mom and then we were talking for like a little bit. But I got here at 4:44 and I just think that's my angel, my spirit guides once again telling me that this is okay. They have my back and everything. So this is my room. It's so cute. Disregard my stuff. I love how it has this mirror, a TV, and then like I have a fridge and a microwave in case I get the munchies, which I know I will. The place is nice. It's just as photographed. This is the bathroom. It's so pretty. And then another cute mirror. Everywhere that I would want to go, like all my excursions, the beach, La Placita, all of that is like 10 to 15 minutes away, which is not terrible because the airport was about 10 to 15 minutes away and it only cost $12, which is great. I'm like dead here by myself. Like I can't even ask somebody like, okay, so what do you feel like doing? Like it's literally just me. It's up to me only. So yeah, I don't know what I'm gonna do. I think I can chill out for a little bit and then later on I'm gonna go out to eat and then possibly bring back leftovers so that I have it for later. And then tomorrow is when we start really living in Puerto Rico, bitch. For like 2 hours just trying to figure out what to do because I didn't plan anything for the first night. So and I just ordered my Uber, so now I have to do what I said I'm gonna do because the Uber's on its way. But I'm going to this rooftop. It's a really pretty rooftop. Everybody's saying that it's 10 out of 10. It's so good. It's such a vibe. So I'm gonna go. I've never did a dinner date solo. So this is just a whole lot of doing things for the first time, and it's a lot. Like, okay, I made it here. That anxiety is gone. Now it's like, okay, bitch, now you actually have to go out and do stuff. So I've just been here, like, trying to recollect myself and be prepared for this. I'm just waiting for my Uber to come. They're 7 minutes away, and it's a woman, which makes me feel safe and happy. This is my outfit. I just kept the pants on because it's cold in here. I doubt that it's cold outside, but I'm gonna just keep this on and then I just change my top and then I have my purse. I'm gonna bring my camera with me and yeah, simple, calm, whatever. Okay, I'm going to the rooftop now. just me. Man, it's so weird.
Okay, I definitely should have brought my tripod with me, but it's a little awkward recording in front of people. But anyways, I'm at a rooftop right now, and I just got this drink. It's called Lucid Dreams. And it's so good. Like, I can see myself ordering like 3 more of these. I don't know how, it doesn't taste strong, it just tastes good. But I do feel a little buzz, not like OD, but I do feel it a little bit. And I still have more left. So I don't know, I can't do too much. And I just ordered food. I just ordered a starter, I didn't order like entree. I don't think I'm gonna get an entree, I'm not that hungry, honestly. But I have to show you guys the view. It's so beautiful.
By the end of this trip, literally.
Oh, and by the way, this place is called Ether. I hope I'm pronouncing it right. Ether, Rooftop, and Lounge. This is the filet mignon steak taquitos on crispy dumpling shells. And then I also got another drink because this drink was so good, and I might get a third one, but we'll see how I feel after I finish this one. But I'm gonna try this and see what it's hitting for.
Getting ready right now. I have this excursion. We're going to the El Yunque waterfall. And you need to have your bathing suit on, so I'm wearing this one piece. And then I'm gonna just put this romper over. And then I'm gonna put on some shoes. And then when it's time to get in the water, just take this off. And then I brought shorts just in case this gets wet. And then, yeah, I'm gonna take my nose ring out because this is a stud and I don't wanna lose it. So I'm gonna take it out and I need to hurry up because I have to leave soon.
Okay, so it's like 6:50 in the morning, and I'm waiting for the bus to come for the excursion. There's a bus right there, but it's full. So I'm just standing here until the next bus comes. I'm excited. I'm going on a hike and I have Vans on, so I'm kind of nervous about that part, but these are the only shoes that I don't mind getting dirty. So yeah, I'm excited. And then we're gonna go to the waterfall and get in the water. My camera on my phone really sucks, but yeah. Oh, I meant to take my nose ring out. I mean, I guess I still can, but I don't want to lose it.
Okay.
Guys, I did so many new things for the first time. I jumped off a cliff. I went down 2 slides, and I swung on a rope into the water. I never do these things, and I'm so happy I did it. Guys, I literally brought my camera, my tripod, and everything, expecting to be able to record during the excursion to El Yunque waterfall and rainforest. But we had to leave all our valuables in the car. And I'm glad I did, because it was a whole full-on hike, like hike. And if I was holding my camera, it just wouldn't have been good. But that was so fun. I took my nose ring out, the stud that I had, and I'm so glad I did, because it definitely would have been lost if I kept it in. But when I tell you, it was so fun, the people were amazing, the tour guide was amazing. Like, it was just, the nature was beautiful. Like, I just don't even know how to describe it in words. I brought my phone with me, so I have like a little bit that I can like show you guys, and I'll like insert it in like the next few clips. But that was so beautiful, and it was like so out of my comfort zone. Like, this whole experience all together is like all new experiences. Like, first time doing a solo trip, first time at Puerto Rico, first time in my own Airbnb. I always go to every time I travel, I either go to a hotel or a resort. 9 times out of 10, I'm at a resort. Then doing a hike, that was my first real hike. That was my first time jumping. I jumped off a cliff, y'all. I jumped off a cliff into the water. That was my first time doing that. It was my first time doing the rope swing into the water. I went down the natural slide. I went down two natural slides. Like, wow. And yeah, and last night I did my first solo dinner date. I had some good Puerto Rican food after the excursion. We stopped to get food. I have a lot of leftovers and just 10 out of 10. And the thing is, it's only 2:20. We did all of that bright and early in the morning and now I have the whole day. I'm a little drained, so I think I'm going to like take maybe like a nap or like rest for like an hour. I'm thinking about going to Piñones for like, there's a beach there and there's also like little kiosks everywhere with drinks and like little food stands and stuff like that. I'm probably not gonna get food because I'm not that hungry, but I'll probably go for the drinks, get some nice mixed drinks.
I like the cocktail better, but I don't want to keep doing the same style, even though it's basically the same though. It's only right to play Bad Bunny in Puerto Rico, so let's play Un Verano Sin Ti.
En la guagua se puede hablar de tu perfume.
Puerto Rico, like this is crazy. I'm at Piñones right now and I'm looking for the mojito bar. I think I'm not in the right place, but it's just a whole strip of restaurants and stuff, and it's so cute here. It's very cute. So I'm gonna just walk and see if I can find something, if I can find the place that I'm looking for. Okay, update. I just looked up the location for the place that I want to visit. It's 20 minutes away, driving. And I'm walking. So we're gonna have to find a different place to get some drinks.
Okay, so I'm currently at Piñones. It's such a cute area here. It's like a beach and then there's so many different restaurants and like bars nearby. So I got a drink. This is a mixed drink. I think I said passion fruit with tequila. And I just made myself a little palette down here. I'm gonna show you the view that I currently see. So beautiful, and this is how I'm gonna spend the rest of my day. Currently it's 6:10 and I'm having a great time so far. I've only been speaking a little Spanish. Like when I was ordering my drink, this guy came up to me, well before I ordered my drink, like I just went near like the restaurant or like the bar, and he asked me, he was like hola, I was like hola. He was like something comer, and I was like no beber, like drink, I want to drink something, and then he pointed me to the direction. So like little small talk I'm doing but I haven't had like a conversation yet, but like little things like in my Uber drive, like in my Ubers I say a little bit of Spanish, but I don't really make conversation in Spanish. So yeah, that's where we're at right now. And then I wanted to journal. I brought my journal with me, but I forgot to bring a pen, so can't journal. But I did bring a book, so I think I'm gonna read a little bit and just chill out, enjoy my time, because earlier was the excursion, the El Yunque waterfall, like the all of that, so I'm pretty drained right now, so this is like the perfect vibe for me right now. So I'm just gonna chill out, relax, and yeah, probably get another drink later today, after this one.
this way. Oh, this is gonna be a pretty sunset, I think. I'm gonna stay here until sunset. I think it'll be so pretty.
Drought and famine, natural disasters. My baby has been around for me.
Okay, I just wanted to read this one. It's very short. Okay, so I'm reading the book, Book of Anonymous Letters, and this one is really short, but it holds a lot of weight, and I feel like it resonates with me a lot because me 2 years ago, I was in shambles. Even last year around this time, I was kind of like, you know. But it says, to my past self, we do get there in the end. We save ourselves. We're happy now and we're living. Like, bitch, I'm here in Puerto Rico by myself. I'm at a beach with a pretty view. The clouds are blocking the sunset, but this is still amazing. I hear the sound of the waves, the view of the waves. I feel amazing. The weather's perfect. And like me 2 years ago, I went through my first breakup, and it was very traumatic for me because, you know, it was the first person I ever felt like I was in love with, and the way that it ended was really tough. So when I was in that moment, I literally felt like there was no escape from that feeling. And here I am now, living. I wonder if I get lit later.
Every time I look into your eyes, I see it. You're all I need. Every time I get a bit inside, I feel it.
Once I get comfortable and like get in my night clothes, first of all, it's only 7:22, but listen, I've had a long day. Like, I was literally out and about at 6:30 in the morning, like, cut me some slack. So I'm just gonna unwind, get comfortable, and then I'm gonna do a little story time for y'all because I was in the Uber and it was like a cute little Uber love story. Okay. I'm not lit, but like, I'm a little lit. But like, as much lit as I could be to be still be responsible, you know what I mean? Like, just a little buzz. But once I unwind, I'm going to do a little girly story time with y'all. Can we first take a moment on how freaking good I look? Like, privilege. Okay.
Yum. This is beef and cheese empanadas. Okay, bitch, let's get to the story time. Ugh, if this could stay. So I went to Piñones tonight and I grabbed a drink. I just vibed out. It was nice. I wasn't there for long. Like, that whole experience was probably altogether like, I was probably there for like an hour and a half to 2 hours, but Once the sunset, I was kind of ready to go, especially because the flies were like all over the place. So I ordered my Uber, and then when I was walking to him, it was a guy. When I was walking to him, I'm like, oh, he's kind of cute. And keep in mind,
I am 100% lesbian, okay? He was cute, not gonna lie. Like, I'll never disregard, like, I would never deny somebody's beauty. He was fine, from what I can see, at least. This bun. And so I get in the car and he's like, what's the first thing he said to me? I think he said hola. And I was like, hola. I think. He was like, Chanel, right? I was like, yes. Before my trip, I customized my Uber, like my settings, so that every time I get in the car, we have to verify the PIN to make sure that we're, you know, they're doing the right person and I'm in the right car. So I was giving him the PIN and I gave it to him in English. And he was able to get all of them except the last one, which was 8. So I said 8. He was like, so I was like, ocho. I was like, ocho. He was like, ocho. And then he was like, my English is like a little bit. And I was like, my Spanish is a little bit too. And then it was quiet. And then in my mind, I'm like, should I ask him how is he? Or like, should I wait until he talks to me? So keep in mind, that's going through my mind for like, I don't remember how long, but it was going through my mind. And then he says something, but he spoke completely in Spanish and it was kind of fast and I could not understand what he said. So I was like, huh? I was like, what'd you say? And then I don't think he understood what I said. So then we were kind of like, we went back and forth, like trying to understand each other. But I told him, I'm like, más despacio, like slow down, say it again. And I said that in English. I was like, say it again. And then he didn't know what I said. He said something. Then I was like, otra vez, like again, say it again. And then I don't know, like I still don't know to this moment what he said the first time. And then he was like, he said something and he said, soy de Puerto Rico. But I'm like, is he asking me? Like, I know that that means I'm from Puerto Rico, but I said, soy de Nueva York. And I was like, soy de Nueva York. He was like, New York. And then he asked me if, no, he was like, New York is, then he was like, New York is very beautiful. And I was like, it is beautiful. And I was like, Puerto Rico too. And I was like, Puerto Rico también. And he was like, he asked me if it was my first time here. And I was like, yeah. And he was like, what for? I'm like, vacation. And that was that. When he dropped me off at my B&B, when we arrived at my B&B, he was like, good night. And I was like, I laughed a little bit. And I was like, good night. Because I was like, oh, he knows how to say that in English. And then I was like, let me say it in Spanish. I was like, buenas noches. He was like, buenas noches. And it was just cute. It was a cute little, like, movie scene. Like, this is not the end, this is the beginning, you know? No, I'm kidding, but yeah, that was it. I'm a little lit right now, so it kind of seems like more than it was, but listen, I am out of my comfort zone. I've been speaking Spanish a little bit, especially to my Uber drivers. All my intentions for the trip is coming true, and that's just, thank you, God. Like, I can't thank you enough. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. I'm happy and grateful that things are going smoothly and that I like you here. I'm gonna give him a good review and I'll tip him well because he did a good job. So his name is Steven. I'm gonna give him 5 stars and I'll give him $5. 5 stars, $5. And then I'm gonna give a compliment too. Great conversation. One of the compliments that you could choose is great conversation. I should press that because it would be kind of like, you know. Okay, so it could either be excellent service, great conversation, expert navigation, entertaining driver, cool car, awesome music, neat and tidy, great amenities, above and beyond, late night hero. I think I'm going to do great conversation because that would just make the most sense for the vibes. Okay, so now I'm just gonna watch some Netflix and chill out until I fall asleep.
guys. So today is Wednesday, May 10th. This is my third day here, but my second full day here. And my original itinerary for today was supposed to be a beach yoga and meditation class. I was so excited for that one, but the host messaged all of us yesterday and was like, she has to cancel, and like she gave us alternative dates that we can go, but I already have everything planned like for the rest of my trip here, so it didn't work out. So instead I booked a tour. So this is my outfit, something calm, just some shorts and a top. We're going inside like a cathedral and everything, so I just wanted to make sure that my outfit is like, you know, acceptable and appropriate. So I have this, and then I also have like a top under this, because after that I'm going out to eat. I'm gonna get like a brunch. And then I also have my bathing suit under this and like a BT outfit in here for the beach. And then I'm gonna come back home and, well, come back to my Airbnb and then switch into my dancing clothes, because I'm gonna be going to a bachata class. So today's gonna be very exciting. I'm about to call my Uber in a minute or two. And yeah, we're gonna learn a little bit about Old San Juan.
Estoy en Parachina, and I just got the pina colada. This is where it originated from, so I'm very excited to try it.
I stopped at this restaurant because they said they have the best mofongo. So I have them right here. I got the chicken mofongo. I wanted to get the pork one because during my tour, one of the Puerto Ricans said that the pork one is the most authentic, but I didn't see it on the menu. So I just got the chicken one, the pollo mofongo, and we're gonna see what it's good for.
Mofongo, 10 out of 10. It's so slap.
Okay guys, I just ate. I brought food to go because I don't know, like my appetite has been really small, but this food is busting. Like if I could eat more, I would, but I'll save it for later. Right now I'm going back to the Columbus Circle, or the Columbus statue, the original place that I started the tour from, and I'm gonna order my Uber from there, and then I'm going to the beach. I'm excited. I really need to get in some water because it's so hot. This is where I'm at. I don't even know if I'm going the right way, honestly. Yeah, right here. All right, I'm gonna just cross the street and then I'm here. This is where we started the tour. Okay guys, I just got to Isla Verde. This is my first time at this beach. It's so pretty and calm here. Oh yes, I love it already. Beautiful.
I still get nerviosa. I forget like what to say when the time comes. But little by little.
Hello. So I'm back at my Airbnb and I'm just chilling right now. I just finished journaling a little bit and I took a shower after I got back from the beach. My dance class got canceled. Literally both of the
Airbnb experiences that I booked for today got canceled. The yoga class got canceled for this morning, and the bachata class got canceled. But it's okay because one, I'm sleepy. Two, I only had one cute dancing outfit, and I'm doing two dance classes. So now both of them are gonna be tomorrow, so I can just wear the cute outfit for both of the classes. But yeah, today was still a successful day. Like, it's only 4 o'clock and I have time to recharge and do something tonight if I want to. So this morning, like you guys saw, I did the Old San Juan tour. I learned a lot about Puerto Rico. The beach was so beautiful. Like, I wish I was like there longer. I wish I stayed there longer. It's so beautiful there. And now I'm just gonna brainstorm to see what I can get into tonight. Because like I said, it's only 4 o'clock and there's so much time left, and time is actually ticking. I have one more full day and then I leave Friday morning, so I want to make the most of the time that I have left here. When I was leaving the beach, actually I talked to people today. Like, on the Old San Juan tour, there was this girl. She started talking to me. She was very nice. She's from, where did she say that she's from? Texas. Yeah, she's from Houston, Texas, and she was there for a mission trip. And we were talking throughout the tour. And then when I went to the beach, when I was leaving the beach, there was this couple, and the girl, she started talking to me. She was asking me, because I was by the bus stop, but that was only so the Uber could find me. And she started talking to me. She was like, have you ever like taken the bus here? And I was like, no, I've just been taking Ubers. And then we just started talking, and she told me that she's from, I don't remember if she said North or South Carolina, but one of the Carolinas. We were talking a little bit. She was cool too. I'm like, oh, like, I just love how like people are gravitating towards me and talking to me. And also on the tour, oh my gosh, let me go back to the tour. There was this Boricua, and she was native to Puerto Rico. She was an older lady, and she just wanted to go on the tour. She was there with her family. She just wanted to go on the tour to learn more about things that she just didn't know. She moved over to New Jersey back, I think she said like 40 years ago. She was just talking, she told me about two restaurants to get the best mofongo. What else was she telling me? She picked up mangoes for me. Well, not for me, but we saw a mango tree and she picked up two mangoes. And then I was like, oh, can I take a picture of the mangoes in your hand? And then she's like, here, here, you can have it. You can have it, because she has family members down here and she's going to them and they have a mango tree in their backyard. She was very sweet. She was like talking to me about the little side things that the tour guide wasn't saying. She was like saying to me and the other girl. She was just very sweet. And like all in all, today was a great day for like talking to people. Just like talking to people. Like, I love how people came up to me and started talking to me. And I don't know. All in all, this is an amazing experience. I'm super grateful. That's something that I was writing in my journal, like how grateful I am. I was literally at the beach and I was just soaking everything in. And I'm like, wow, like, I'm really in Puerto Rico right now. I'm truly here right now by myself. I feel amazing. I feel on top of the world. Like, this is the best decision of my life. Just an amazing experience.
When I tell y'all they are blasting music outside, just wait. Like, I know that another song is coming soon. It's gonna come. Hold on. I'm gonna let it do its thing.
Guys, I forgot to record when I got here, but I'm at the T-Mobile district, Distrito T-Mobile, and it's literally like a whole plaza. Like, it's so beautiful here. But I'm at this restaurant, and I ordered tacos, and I finally got elotes. When I tell you I've been craving elotes for mad long, and I can finally get some. And then I also ordered a frozen margarita, piña flavored, and it's so good. Like, tonight is ladies' night, and it's unlimited margaritas for $30. And I said, can I just get one to see if like I like it? But I think, I don't know, because I feel like unlimited is kind of OD, especially because it's just me. But this is really good. But I don't know how many I can drink, you know what I mean? Like, I don't want to do the unlimited and only drink like two or three, you know what I mean? But I'm going to show you the plaza, and I'm also going to show you my food.
My elote is so good. And then my say that this is so liberating. Like, I am on my second solo date, and it's just amazing. Like, this view, I'm gonna show you my view. This is what I'm seeing right now while I eat.
Like hours later, and I went somewhere and came back, and they're still playing music. I love it.
Guys, first of all, the people out there is literally jamming. Literally jamming. But I went to the Distrito T-Mobile, the T-Mobile district. It's so beautiful there. Like, who would have thought a phone company has a whole plaza? Literally, there's a movie theater in there, tons of like little restaurants that you go to, bars. There's like this whole, a whole like scenery of screens you can watch. It's like a play, like a mini playground with games. There's an arcade. I don't know if it was an arcade or what is it called? I don't know, but anyway.
Yeah.
And oh my gosh, bitch. First of all, at the place, like I said, they were doing bottomless mimosas. And I considered it. And I'm so glad I didn't do bottomless mimosas, because I had two and I'm already feeling like... You know what I mean? So I was like, if I did bottomless, it just wouldn't have been good. And then, bitch, the icing on the fucking cake, I left my wallet in my beach bag. I only have my purse with me. I only had this purse. And my wallet was in here, bitch. So when I realized that I didn't have my wallet, in my mind, I'm just like, oh shit, oh shit, oh shit, oh shit. So as soon as my waitress came, I was like, do you guys take Apple Pay? She's like, yeah, we take Apple Pay. And I was like, oh, heavens above, because I truly don't know what I would have done if they didn't take Apple Pay. I was thinking in my head, I'm like, okay, well, if they don't take Apple Pay, then hopefully she has Cash App or like Zelle, then I could give her the payment and then she could pay. You know what I mean? I was really like thinking, but I'm so glad that they took Apple Pay. I mean, then again, it is part of like the US, so they should have the same things that we have. But you never know, because this is a whole different, you know? But I'm just, thank you, God, for having Apple Pay and creating Apple Pay, because, whew. It's not that late. It's about, I think it's 9 right now. Hold on, let me check. Yes, it's actually 9 on the dot. It's 9 on the dot, and I'm just going to chill out. I've been going to sleep really early. But like, that's nothing new. Like, when I'm at home, I go to sleep just as early. So especially because I'm on like a solo trip, so I don't have anybody forcing me to be up. I don't have anybody forcing me to be out. So I did everything I had to do today. I'm glad I went out a second time, because knowing me, one thing I don't want to go back out. But like, I keep thinking to myself, like, girl, you're on vacation, you're in Puerto Rico, bitch. Like, this is your first solo trip. You need to go out and explore. So I always go out early in the morning. I come back around like 4 or 5. I chill out and then I go back out for the night and then I come back and then that's it.
Oh my gosh, I forgot to tell y'all about my Uber driver. So it was an older man, and he spoke English, but only a little bit. No, he said he only spoke a little bit of English, but he was very good at his English. I was giving him the code and he asked me, he was like, so do you know any Spanish? And I'm like, yeah, I know a little bit. And I was like, I said un poco, and then he was like, un poquito. And then that kind of confused me, because when I was in Dominican Republic, the people who I was talking to there, they were like, do you speak Spanish? And I was like, un poquito. And she was like, un poco. So now I'm like, okay, so it's un poco. And then here, this is the second time somebody said un poquito. So I'm like, which one is right? Because the first time I was saying un poquito before, and the lady corrected me, she said un poco. So I don't know. I don't know which one it is. Somebody please
inform me so I can learn. And then I told him that I was way better at like reading and writing than speaking and listening. He was like, give it like 6 months and you'll be able to speak Spanish. And then at the end, I was like, okay, this is my chance. Cause I've been wanting to say que tenga un buen día for the longest time. But every time it's time for me to say it, I don't say it. So I was like, okay, let me say it this time. But I was like, oh shit, it's nighttime. And then that's when we stopped right in front of my B&B, and I was like, que tenga un buen noche. He was like, ah, yes, like he was happy that I said that. I was happy that I said it too. Little by little, poco y poco, I'm speaking more Spanish. I know how to say speaking. Yo estoy hablando más español. So proud of myself.
Honestly, this right here is what I live for. Like, I'm in an Airbnb. I think this is a king bed. I have a whole king bed to myself. I'm about to eat my leftovers and I'm gonna watch Netflix. And I got Puerto Ricans blasting music outside. Like, life just can't get any better right now. And I have a lot of leftovers too. Like, a lot. I have two elotes. I have 1.5 carne asada tacos, and then I have a whole side of rice and smashed beans. I don't know what it's called. I know it's like, I'm pretty sure this is beans, but like, what do they call it? But like, this is a whole like plate. I probably won't even finish this, but I do want a little bit more, so.
Okay, so I'm here for my dance class, La Vergüenza. I'm so excited to do my little salsa class. It's so cute up here. So I just finished my salsa class and now we're eating lunch. I got, what did I get? This is a margarita, pineapple flavored again, but not frozen this time. And then I got mofongo. I got it with the pork this time. So it's some of my first time trying it, like that. And this one is different. It's like inside.
I just finished with my salsa class and I ate lunch. I had mofongo with chicharron. And I also had a margarita. And now I'm walking to the beach, which is only 7 minutes away. It's so beautiful in Condado. Honestly, all of Puerto Rico is so beautiful. Like, I'm in awe. I don't want to leave. I leave tomorrow morning and I'm kind of sad about it. But this is my view. Like, oh my gosh, I love it here. I will move here. Okay, I'm at the beach. This one is Condado Beach. So all together, I've been to Piñones, I've been to Isla Verde, and now Condado. I think out of all of them, my favorite one would have to be Isla Verde. The one that I was at yesterday. It wasn't that many people. The beach was beautiful. This one is beautiful too. I just love the beach.
For my bachata class. This is what I also wore for the salsa class with some sneakers. I'm sleepy. Like, I was thinking about how I also gotta go to the LED paddleboard thing tonight, and I'm just like, I'm sleepy. And I'm also supposed to be going to La Placita tonight with my friends. So, because, like, honestly, like, this is just too much in one day. I did a dance class, I went to the beach. That alone is enough. Like, anyways, I'm ready to dance bachata. Okay guys, I'm back from the dance class. I didn't record anything because it was so intimate. Like, it was literally just me and one other girl learning bachata with like this grandma. She was so sweet, she was so adorable. But I basically gave you the gist of what I learned. So I'm gonna do a little
bachata dance for y'all. Hold on, let me prop y'all up.
Okay, y'all, first I want to say that I'm back at my B&B, as y'all can see, and then I'm gonna have to take another Uber to go to the paddle boat thing, and then still gotta go to La Placita because my friend is here and she asked me if I was still down, but my energy is deteriorating and like I'm tired. But anyways, let me put on a bachata song and I'm gonna show y'all what I learned. It just taught us the regular 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, how to do it in place. And we each took a turn dancing with the teacher and she taught us how to spin both ways and how to allow them to spin. And we just did like different spins and like how to do forward, how to do backwards, but nothing fancy, you know, nothing fancy. When I tell y'all I am bit the hell up, like, it's actually ridiculous. It, like, is all over my leg. Like, I'm suffering right now, bro. Y'all, I am so tired, but I was literally in bed in, like, pajamas, and I was really contemplating not going, but my Uber is coming. He'll be here in a minute, and I got myself up to do the LED paddle boat. I'm just wearing something calm because I may get a little wet, so let's just wear something comfy, like shorts and a tee. So that's what I'm wearing. I'm not gonna bring my camera because I feel like that's a little too risky. My Uber is here. I think that's a little too risky, so I'm just gonna record on my phone. All right, bye. Okay, so I'm here. You have to go under the white tent to meet up with my group. Y'all can't even see me, but I'm in the middle of, I don't even know what this is, in a kayak. In a kayak, bitch. Okay, so, so this is the paddleboard. It has a little bit of LED. And then this is the city. It looks beautiful. But like, this is a big body of water right now that I'm in the middle of by myself. Oh my God. Y'all, I'm so dumb because I have a little light thing that could clamp to my phone and I forgot to bring it. I'm sad. These are the other people kayaking by myself in the middle of a lagoon at 9:30 p.m. This is my life. Y'all, this is my little war paint. I tried to do a little something. Y'all, honestly, I told myself that I just need to go out and just do it, especially because I paid for it. But not gonna lie, I could have saved the money. And if I didn't go, I wouldn't have missed out on anything. It was an experience, like, I'm glad I did it. I can say I did it, I guess. But, and in the middle of it, I was like, what the heck did I sign up for? My arms were hurting. It was dark. I was lonely. I was in the middle of a big body of water. I'm like, am I crazy? Like, am I actually insane? So yeah, that was that experience. Now I have to wash all this war paint off and get a little bit of rest and then get ready for La Placita tonight. And I'm gonna meet up with my friend Steph and her friend. I'm tired, but I have to end my last night with a bang. Like, I just have to. All right, you guys, last night, last activity, I'm going to La Placita. I'm meeting up with my friends and this is the outfit. I have some lashes on tonight. And yeah, some shoes. Honestly, I'm tired as hell, but we gotta end it with a banger.
I'm not gonna get too lit, but I just wanna experience it. So, yeah, guys. All right, bye.
Okay, it's like 2 a.m. and we're leaving La Placita now. I don't wanna leave, but they're leaving, so I'm leaving soon.
Hi guys, so it is 2:52 in the morning and I just recently got back. This is my last night here in Puerto Rico, and honestly, like, I feel like this was the most amazing trip ever, because like I spent like most of my days doing everything on my own, and then my very last day my friend from New York comes and her friend comes, and like all in this one trip I was able to have the best of both worlds. And like, this was the most amazing trip I've ever had. Honestly, I considered changing my flight like multiple times. 10 out of 10, most amazing experience I've ever had. I really recommend everybody to do a solo trip at least one time in their life. When I tell you I had the best time of my life, like, I'm extremely grateful, and like, I'm so happy that I got to experience La Placita. Now, La Placita was 10 out of 10. I can only imagine what it's like on the weekends. I'll be back, trust me, I'll be back. I'm just so grateful for the experience. Like, I don't think anybody understands. Like, once you do a solo trip, you'll understand. Like, wow, it literally unlocks a new version of you. Like, now you're unstoppable. Now you can do whatever you want in your life. But yeah, y'all. All right. Have a great night. I'm definitely gonna have a great night. I feel lit. I took maybe, I don't remember how many shots I took, but I took a decent amount of shots. And I feel lit right now, and I hit for my pen as well. Good night. Love you. Love this experience. Love life. Love everything. I promise. I literally promise I'll be back. Truly. Okay. Bye, guys. Okay, guys. The time has come for me to check out of my Airbnb and go to the airport. I'm wearing the same thing that I wore here back home. And so I had so much fun. I felt like I didn't even sleep last night. I felt like I was sleeping for like 2 seconds and then I had to wake up. But I have all my stuff here and I'm ready to go. Thank you, Airbnb, for keeping me safe and doing what you needed to do in my time here. Puerto Rico, I'm gonna miss you so much, but I'm gonna be back. I promise you, I'm going to be back. Honestly, I think this may have been the best trip I've ever taken in my entire life. So yeah, guys, this is your sign to do a solo trip. This is your sign. If you've been wanting to do it. 10 out of 10. Highly recommend. I have to say something in Spanish before I go. Me encanta Puerto Rico. How do I say I will be back? I will be. Yo estaré atrás, I think. Yo estaré atrás. Let's see if I'm right. Volveré. I mean, I had the same idea. Let's see. Yo estaré atrás. I'll be back. Period. Yeah, guys, I'll be back. Volveré pronto.